It's Wednesday, August the 3rd, and you're listening to the God Minute. Brothers and sisters, this is Father Michael, along with the rest of our team, gathered here in the chapel to praise our God and to allow this moment of grace to bring us to a deeper relationship with the Lord and one another. Welcome. Let us begin as we do all things in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 119, Section 2, Giving Back. You forgive me when I fail, O Lord, and you set me on my feet again. You have promised to strengthen me and sustain me in my daily conflicts.
Now I pray for the wisdom to discern your will and the grace to carry it out in the days before me. You have shown me how much you love me, Lord. Now, show me how to love you back.
I can truly love you only as I proceed to love your children in this world. I can serve you only as I commit my life to service on behalf of my brothers and sisters.
I can offer sacrifices to you only as I sacrificed to meet my neighbor's need. This is your law and standard, your design and will for my life. This is the way in which I will be pleasing to you.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 15, verses 22 and 24 to 28. A Canaanite woman called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." He said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did homage, saying, "Lord, help me." He said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, for even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed from that hour. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You know, at first glance, this story does not reflect the Jesus that I've come to know. Why does he refuse to help this woman and her suffering child? It almost seems like he's reserving his healing power for a select few, namely the house of Israel. "I was only sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel," he says. And what's with the reference to the dog? "Take food from the children and throw it to the dogs." Well, that feels a bit insulting, doesn't it? I think he's implying she's a dog. Not very flattering, for sure. What is going on here? Well, Jesus isn't being mean. He's being real. Historically, there was a big separation between the chosen people and everyone else. The Messiah, prophesied in the Old Testament, was coming for the chosen people, the Israelites. Initially, that was Jesus' primary focus. The arrival of Jesus is the fulfillment of what was foretold in the Old Testament. The Canaanite woman acknowledges this when she calls Jesus Lord, Son of David. She's aware of who he is. She's very much on the outside of the circle looking in. And yet, her faith is so much greater than people who had been studying and waiting for the Messiah for years and years. She's not a lost sheep at all. The commitment to her belief in Jesus and his saving power was so great that she could not be discouraged. She was persistent in her request, relentless even. Maybe Jesus' words to her are a test or a challenge to see how committed she really is. Not because he doesn't already know what's in her heart. He is God, after all. But maybe he wants to show the disciples who are witnessing this encounter the benefit of her persistence. I don't know. I say maybe because I don't really want to assume that I might know what Jesus was thinking. Over and over again in the Bible, we seem to see that God's ways are not our ways. Who am I to say what God was thinking? But the woman, she's not even deterred by being compared to a dog. Even the dogs get the scraps, she says. She's not asking for everything. She's willing to just take the leftovers. She's committed. She is determined. She is filled with unwavering faith in the Lord. Oh, to be more like her. When it feels like God's not answering our prayer in the way that we would like, with a speed that matches the urgency of our requests. If she could talk to us today, I think the Canaanite woman would say, keep the faith. Don't give up. God is good. With a sincere and humble heart, keep asking. Your prayer will be answered.
For the gift of perseverance today, and for all of our individual needs, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. God of my heart, you are great indeed. Help us to treasure the scraps that you give and send our way. Let us see them as the greatest treasures that we could ever receive, and so use them to glorify you and to serve our brothers and sisters through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Here's something to look forward to for this Saturday on the God Minute. There's another in our Rosary video series that we are going to present to you, where we pray a full rosary together with beautiful images playing in the background. Last month, we did the one on the men speaking, and then this Saturday is a walk in the woods. So set aside about 20 minutes for this Saturday and join us in prayer as we pray the full rosary with Father Ron and Sister Anne and the team. Okay? Brothers and sisters, take good care of yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow.